Yeah, money.
Millionaire, I'm a young money millionaire, tougher than Nigerian hair. My criteria compared to your career just isn't fair. I'm a venereal disease, like a menstrual bleed through the pencil and leak on the sheet of the tablet in my mind. Cause I don't write shit, cause I ain't got time. Cut my seconds, minutes, hours go to the almighty dollar in the almighty power of that chopper. Sister, brother, son, daughter, father, motherfucker.
Get you hemmed up while I'm being tailored. Then I slide off to the side like a faker. Call me, I'm the president, governor, and maker. I control everything like a dictator. Get you bands marked up, turn you into vapors. If you got a problem, get you swallowed like a chaser.
Yo, what's happening, YouTube? This is your friendly homeboy, Dreaded One Leo, coming at you with my first ever YouTube video. This particular video is a special video because this video is the first video in my personal Loc journey. So, I guess starting off, then I should talk about why I decided to get my hair locked up. I didn't do it for any particular reason, like style, religion, or you know, spiritual thing like that. Although I have always been a fan of dreads or locks, whatever you want to call them, I like to refer to them as locks. I've always liked them and been a fan of them, but never really wanted to get them because I didn't want it to get it to be cliche or like just get them because people was getting them and was rocking them. You know, I wanted to have my understanding of the style of hairdress and my own reasons behind it. So the reasons that I did it was to learn of more patience and commitment about myself. You know, patience and commitment are the two things I think we struggle with in life, and so I figured that doing this would be a good way for me to deal with those things.
This is my second week with my hair locked up. I did a video for day 4, like when I first got it done, but the camera, the mic wasn't working out. So this is my first Loc journey video, and I'm simply just gonna give you some information about what I use and why I decided to lock my hair up. So I guess first of all, the reason why I personally decided to lock my hair up wasn't for anything like spiritual or like cultural reasons. It was more personal. More about me dealing with, you know, patience and commitment. That's my main thing, you know what I mean? So, you know, because it take a lot of commitment to do dreads or locks or whatever you want to call them. Take a lot of commitment to do that and a lot of patience. So, so far, so good. I was growing my hair for about a month and a half before I decided to twist it up. I originally planned on going to get it done by a loctician professionally, and I still plan on going to see a loctician, but at some point, just for maintenance and just upkeep and pointers and whatnot. But at this point right now, I'm doing it on my own. I decided to use the towel method to start my locks. I ran up on that at, you know, just messing with my hair with a towel, and I just noticed that it started to roll up. So I did some research and realized it's actual method. So now what I decided to use as far as products, well, before I even locked my hair up, I would wash it, you know, every couple of days, but mainly I just used 100% virgin coconut oil on my hair. That's pretty much what I use all over, you know what I'm saying? I don't use lotions and a lot of processed stuff because it's not really good for the hair or skin. So once I decided to lock it up, I decided to go with the Jamaican mango lime. Appreciate everybody who repped it. This is a good product. Unfortunately, when I first got it, my hair was still a little was shorter than it is now, of course. But it didn't want to hold well, I guess because of the texture of my hair or whatnot, whatever. So I went and got a little something a little heavier, and I got this black beeswax. This is good too. But I think I'm more of a fan of the mango. Personally, now that it's locked up, I put it in. It's real light, but it works well. And don't smell crazy either, you know. But it's good stuff. So far, I'm happy with that. Both products I'm happy with, though. I use a black towel to twist my hair. Regular towel like that. I wet the hair. Put a little bit of the... actually, I put a lot of the wax on there. Well, pretty much just enough like you're putting grease in your hair. I run it through real good. I come through with the towel. And I don't want to let my hair drip. You know what I'm saying? I run it with some water on my hands. Run it through my hair, put this in there, run it through real good, and then while it's moist and slightly moist, and then with the mango lime, I go ahead and I twist. You know what I'm saying? I rub in one direction. I usually like to go towards the front, and I start at one corner and work my way back like that. One corner, work my way back, and I try to concentrate on the palm. The palm does all the work for me in nice even circles. And so far, my hair's been happy with it, you know. I think your hair's got fitting, personally, you asked me. And right now, my head's happy. So, it's cool. So, I'm just going to let y'all look at it real quick, what it's doing. And like I said, it had been about 2 weeks now. They're starting to hold on their own, lock up. Doing it this way seems like it could be a little small, but that's cool for me because that way, if at any point I need to make adjustments or I need to change anything, I can. I don't know how good you can see that because I had a live tech cam before and I had some problems with the mic on that, so I had to switch to the digital. So I'm hoping I get good shots right here. So we're going to walk this around like this, try to get some light. Let that go around like that. Now, I don't know if any... Now, personally, the only issue I have with locking my hair... Excuse me. One issue I have locking my hair is that, like, the men in my family, genetically bald quick, you know, or bald first in the middle, you know what I'm saying? So I've been trying to combat that just by eating healthy and eating a lot, drink a lot of water, and then eating things that's good for promoting hair growth. I mean, so we'll see what happens. You know what I'm saying? So far, holding up good. Hopefully I'll get to the point where I get mid age or some shit around, you know, some 40 and shit, and I'll be breaking off or whatever, but. As of right now, I think I'm going to have a nice, pretty full, thick head of locks, and I'm excited about my lock journey. I appreciate everybody that put out information before me that helped me get on the right track. And if anybody has any more information about locks, upkeep, or methods, and things like that nature, I want to just appreciate everybody for all the advice, you know what I'm saying, and the tips and pointers. Keep it up, man. I'd like to continue to share my journey with y'all. I did a video before, but I had some issues with that one earlier. This is me doing my official lock video. Today's March 2nd. April 2nd, 2009. So I appreciate y'all viewing. Be sure to subscribe. And I holla.